my buddy Rob told me that he found a hedge, and it looks quite old. There's a lot of moss on it. I'm not sure. We can see if we can open it. First off, we're gonna pick up a friend. Today, I'm with my buddy Rob from Road to Two Unknown. We actually found some very authentic, cool places that we think are really worth to check out. These were places behind the German front lines. And yeah, a lot of German soldiers would gather up here. And yeah, let's hope there's still enough history to be shared. There's a deer somewhere over there in the back. Can you see it? We haven't even started up and That's really cool to see. It's nature out there, guys. It's still there. Yeah, there she goes. See even more of them. See that? Wow. So I guess that's my first decent signal of the day. Let's see what it is. Somewhere over there. We seem to have found something American. It's a Browning 50 caliber shell casing. Wasn't really expecting that here. 44 it says on the bottom, 1944. I'm not sure how well you can see it, but I just stumbled upon a major trench. You can very clearly make out a zigzag shape. Goes like that, all the way through here. And also there in the back, very cool, a running trench. Well, we just started off detecting, and you'll never believe it, but my buddy Rob over there, who's already working on his second signal, his first signal was actually a Nazi coin. And I think he's actually brushing it up right now. Jeez, do we already know what type of coin it is?
I'm not sure. I can see a swastika in the middle, but
it's very shiny.
Yeah, it's,
we like finding those. Yeah. Well, at least the swastika is very clear. Mm-hmm. I think it's a Deutsche Reichspfennig from probably 1935, somewhere that range. And it's a 10 pfennig. Have you ever dreamt of setting out on quests to discover lost treasures? Then this metal detecting course is for you. I'm going to walk you through all important aspects of this exciting hobby so you don't make all the beginner's mistakes. My name's Chris, I am a detectorist and a YouTuber. 10 years ago, I decided to share my passion with the world by creating documentaries about how I use my metal detector to find forgotten treasures and my attempts to find the history behind each relic. I have partnered up with International Open Academy to create this metal detecting course, which will give you a complete overview of the hobby and goes far beyond reading a simple manual. You'll gain valuable knowledge that would take years to learn by doing it yourself. So don't look any further, because this course will teach you everything you need to know about metal detecting. Simply click on the link and enroll. Here's actually one of my first signals in this forest over here. And it's an American find. It's quite a good sign, I think. Dug it out already. It's an M1 carbine casing. And they're quite easy to recognize. They look a bit like a 9mm, but they are a bit longer. So yeah, American find. M1 carbine, live round, unfortunately, so we cannot take this with us. In June 1940, the US Army came up with specifications for a light rifle that could replace the 45 pistol and the submachine gun. In September 1941, it became clear that the M1 carbine would take this role, and it was put into action in 1942. The M1 carbine saw action in World War II, the Korea War, and even the Vietnam War. We decided to leave the forest behind us and detect this beautiful field. We got some permission from the farmer, and we did some research and found out that there were quite some American tents on this field. So we're gonna set up and see what the first find.
Let's carry on. Right then, let's see what this is. I think there's something there. And it looks quite shiny. Look at that, guys. That's definitely a German Erkennungsmarke, a dark tag. Let me just get my other camera for a close-up. Look at this. Really happy with this. It's a part of a German dark tag. The writing is very clearly readable. It's a half one and it's bent. Landesschutzersatzbataillon 6, I think it says. That's a cool one. Personal find. I mean, a German soldier has carried this for years around his neck, so it doesn't get much more personal than that, I would say. Look at this, guys. I had a signal right there and no digging needed here. Can you see it? It's right on the surface. And it's an American uniform button, I think. I'm quite sure. It's the American Eagle. Small one, there's also bigger ones. I haven't found those yet, but my buddy Rob has. So I can show you a photo or image of those in a little bit. Or I'm just gonna have to find them myself. And I probably will. I'll get back to you in a couple of minutes, hopefully. Like I said, I only needed a couple of minutes. Look at this. I think we got our first American uniform button right here. See how big that is, that's huge. This clayey soil preserves the finds here quite well. Let's see if you can clean this up a little bit. I'm just gonna give that a quick brush and I'll get back to you. And there you go, that's the American symbol. It's an American overcoat button. Definitely a very neat button. Well, I was about to pack up my stuff. Just found the American uniform button here, but I got a signal right next to it. And there is actually a coin on the surface right there. Let me just pick it up. Not sure if you can see what type of coin it is. Ooh, I think there's a German eagle on it with the swastika. There we go. That's a very nice coin. But right now I gotta get to my friend John because he was shouting and I think that he got something nice. So we're gonna see. Let's see what he got. John just found a golden Kriegsmarine button, he told me.
Yeah, I did.
That's amazing. It actually says Kriegsmarine.
Yeah. There's a little stamp on the bottom side.
And the other side? There you go. Very special button. Happy with that. And a couple of meters besides it, he finds a Winterhilfswerk badge. And he's cleaning it right now.
It's a little shield. And I think there should be a little stone in the middle.
Yeah, I think there's an eagle as well, and that's the pattern here, an eagle inside.
I think you're right.
He couldn't wait to show me the following.
It's a sport badge.
German sport badge. There's also a swastika on it, right?
Yeah, yeah, it's a little bit folded, a little bit bent.
Yeah, Jesus, man, that's quite nice condition.
I already cleaned it, so.
Yeah, you can see some a red color from copper oxidation. The pin is broken off, as you can see. Well, that's another medal. I'd call this a good day. I just found out that the guys from World War II Unknown found even more badges. Some badges that I haven't even filmed yet. So here we go. This is an officer's cap emblem. And this is an assault badge.
Yeah, general assault badge, yeah.
General one. So we read about it and so they were handed out to soldiers who were not in the infantry but have taken part in some assaults. So it's quite an interesting badge. Well, Rob said he definitely had something that he wanted to show me.
Look at this.
Jesus.
A golden ring.
Golden ring.
Yeah, it's inscripted with 17-9-29. So probably this guy is married in 29.
Jeez, man, no corrosion at all. That's pure gold. Wow, that's a great find, man. We had a closer look at it. There's an E and an H in it. And the date says 17-9-29. Yeah, so the soldier got married in September of 1929. That is a long time ago, I can tell you that. While I was explaining John which row I already walked, he had quite a high signal when he was walking on my row and he said, "You probably don't want to dig up this insignia, do you?" So I laughed at him and yeah.
Who's laughing now?
Luke was laughing now. He actually found an insignia. He joked about it, but it's true. It's a German officer's cap badge. You can see the cockade here. Around it is the wreath. This part is bent over, because you can still see the pin on the back. That's a very nice insignia, man. There's a part missing here. What did the detector give off? What sort of signal?
91. Yeah, pretty high.
Pretty nice signal.
Very cool insignia, man. Let's see if you can clean it up a little. Is it made from aluminum?
Yeah, I think so.
There's almost no oxidation. There's a lot of detail on that.
Yeah, wow. You can see the oak leaves.
Oak leaves, yeah. This is actually a Luftwaffe officer's cap badge, as these badges have both wings and oak leaves. Well, we've been at it for a couple of hours now. I had to put down my stuff for a minute. It's time for a lunch break. And I'm gonna put some finds here in a minute and show you what we found so far. Here's that close-up that I was talking about. This is what me and John found in the last hours. Rob also found some really great stuff. Maybe I can show you some of that later. But first off, let me just walk you through these finds so far. Great variety of buttons, some American uniform buttons, also German Wehrmacht buttons with the clear pattern of dots on it. And then these are some, I think, American ration bags, coffee, lemonade, that sort of stuff. Bunch load of coins here. This very nice German officer's cap emblem that John found. I also found this wing. It's probably from the same badge, actually. So this one would go somewhere over here. And yeah, maybe these are bits from German dog tags. I found one complete one here. It's very, very clearly readable. Landesschutzersatzbataillon 6. But yeah, great haul so far. Let's see what we can dig up more. Clearly there is enough to be found on this field. We actually did find much more there, but you'll find out more about that in the next video. Can't wait to see more? Become a patron and get access to an exclusive video with bonus scenes. For now, we decided to head back in the neighboring forest to get a better feel for the area. Quite a funny moment here just now. I think I just picked up one shovel and threw some dirt to the side. I had a very clear signal right here. And I noticed something interesting, so I call over my buddy Rob to come check it out. So we can do this discovery together. You can see something over here. It looks like it's from a deer or something, the symbol. I'm not sure if this is World War II, but it looks a bit like a badge.
Sort of Jaeger badge, maybe?
Yeah, maybe. Oh, it looks really neat, man.
It is a badge.
You think so?
Yeah.
A German badge.
I think so, yeah.
Wow, if it is one, it's definitely gonna be a special one. Wow, it looks really nice. It turns out that this is a post-war German Hunters Association badge. Well, it seems that more and more signals are starting to pop up. And I actually found something interesting right here. As you can see, there's glass everywhere. I might have encountered a small dump pit, but I saw something blue sticking out of the soil and I just pulled it out. And it's a Nivea cream box. I found this before in the past. This is something that soldiers used to keep their skin in good condition, basically. And yeah, they're very iconic. They still have the same design and you can buy it today, still. Yeah, very nice one, Nivea green box. We might have stumbled upon something interesting here. My buddy Rob told me that he found a hatch and it looks quite old. There's a lot of moss on it. I'm not sure. We can see if we can open it. What's inside? You think it's a shelter from the Second World War? It's filled with rocks. I'm not quite sure what the idea is of this thing, but maybe it was a shelter for civilians that they could take cover, or even for the German soldiers themselves. Who knows? I see another hatch right there, by the way. Uh-huh. Not sure if we can open that one as well, but... Well, very intriguing.
So you're going inside?
I don't think I'm going to go inside, but thank you. Right, don't get your fingers in between. Well, that's that, I guess. I'm gonna continue this adventure next time. I can already promise you that there's gonna be some incredible discoveries that you don't wanna miss out on. Don't forget to check out the merchandise on our website. Big thank you to my patrons as always. See you soon. Cheers.